What kind of child were you at primary school? How would you describe yourself?
Shy, withdrawn, ingrown. Constantly afraid of being beaten up in the schoolyard. Not playing much of a role in any activities. Hoping to get away from school as soon as I could.
Why? Because it was...
I just felt awkward and, unable to join in things.
For what reason? Because...
Don't know. It's just a fairly early memory of being asocial.
The schoolyard, do you remember? You're standing alone, or...
Yeah, actually, my memories aren't very strong until about the age of 8 or 7 or 8, something uh-huh. like that. And I was always being moved from school to school. I think I went to 7 or 8 different primary schools. And in each one, I would always sort of wonder if I were going to make any friends and then never did.
But in a way, the shyness,
don't know.
Where did it come from? Did it accompany you all your life or just in childhood?
I've never been very easy in my dealings with people. I mean, I'm a lot better than when I was a child, but still, I tend to avoid parties because I can't think of any small talk to make.
Do you remember, because if you're talking about yourself as a shy boy escaping into schoolyards, escaping the others in the classrooms, going from school to school, 7 or 8 times, you might suppose that there's somebody who reads books in the silence of his room at home. Am I correct?
Yeah. Yeah, according to my parents, I pretty much taught myself to read when I was 4 or thereabouts and, spent most of the rest of my life reading books.
The world in those books, was it perhaps more important to you
much
than
more.
The world outside?
Yeah, much more. The world outside never quite lived up to the books, except for a few scenes in nature, animals, birds, flowers.
What kind of world were you creating by reading books and combining them? To what kind of picture you?
Oh, fantasies of power, control, omnipotence, sort of usual childhood fantasies, turning out to be the unacknowledged son of the king, that kind of thing.
Power,
yeah.
Control. The control and power you missed dearly at school, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I think basically I was looking for some way to get back at the schoolyard bullies by turning into some kind of intellectual and acquiring some kind of intellectual power, though I wasn't quite clear how this was going to work.
Did you manage?
Sorry?
To come back to them as the intellectual?
No, I just lost touch with them by living in a world of intellectuals.
During adulthood, after primary school, the situation remained the same? That's to say, you escaping the vulgarity of all daily life and entering into the world of books and fantasy?
Well, actually, I was very lucky because when I was 15, I went to the university. And it was a particular program in a particular university where nobody talked about anything except books. So it was, it was ideal for me. And it was the first situation in which I felt more or less at ease and in control of things.
Was there any feeling you had at that time in your childhood or later in your adulthood that you had to become a philosopher?
I think philosophy was somewhat accidental. I mean, I think that I could equally well have become an intellectual historian or a literary critic, but it just happened that the course that I was most intrigued by when I was 16 was a philosophy course. And so I sort of kept taking more and more philosophy courses and signing up for more and more degrees. And
why were you intrigued? Because of
I think because of the sense of mastery and control that you get out of philosophical ideas, you get the impression from reading philosophy that now you can place everything in order or in a neat arrangement or something like that. And this gratifies one's need for domination.
And compensation of the shyness.
Yeah.